Welcome back to Kids Church Online!
Okay.
This week, we are going to talk about being a part of a bigger family. I believe you are as excited as me. So let's get on our feet because it's praise and worship time!
We're on the cars to follow you all our day. Knowing of course that God is good always, always. You know me, you love me, I trust you with my life. Your word is, shows me a little bit more each day and every night. With every twist, with every turn, Jesus, you're my guide. I will listen and I will learn, change my heart inside, and help me bring glory to you, my King. What I'm saying is, Jesus, I am in. We're on the course to follow you all our days, knowing of course that God is good always. Always, you know me, you love me, I trust you with my life. Your word is, shows me a little bit more each day and every night. With every twist, with every turn, Jesus, you're my guide. I will listen and I will learn, change my heart inside, and help me bring glory to you, my King. What I'm saying is, Jesus, I am in. I'm gonna dance the dance, top the top. I'm gonna live the life. I'm gonna walk this walk. I'm gonna dance the dance, top the top. I'm gonna live the life. I'm gonna walk this walk. I'm gonna dance the dance, top the top. I'm gonna live the life. I'm gonna walk this walk. With every twist, with every turn, Jesus, you're my guide. I will listen and I will learn, change my heart inside, and help me bring glory to you, my King. What I'm saying is, Jesus, I am in. With every twist, with every turn, Jesus, you're my guide. I will listen and I will learn, change my heart inside, and help me bring glory to you, my King. What I'm saying is, Jesus, I am in. What I'm saying is, Jesus, I am in.
Hello friends, we're going to pray for USA today. Come and join me. Dear Father God, thank you for all your blessings this week. We come together today to pray for USA. Please have mercy on them, Lord, and ensure that their daily COVID cases will go down and that all their COVID patients will be healed by casting your divine healing over them, Lord. As you have said that if your people who are called by your name will humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from their wicked ways, you will hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. Please also bless the upcoming elections, Lord, and ensure that the new government will be God-fearing and full of wisdom, as we believe that all the authorities on earth have been established by you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Everything I'll be, I'll give it to you.
Shalom kids, my name is Andrileo Andrilei, the coolest professor who will always show you the coolest experiment. So since we are learning about family this month, my experiment will also be related very much about family in Christ. And of course, to do this experiment, I will need some materials. The first one is a spoon, and then a food coloring. In this case, I picked three colors here, red, green, and yellow. And a glass of cooking oil. And lastly, is a jar of water. So, wait, before I do the experiment, let me change my glasses first. Since I am a professor. So we are ready now. So how are we going to do the experiment? Let's watch. So the food coloring here represents us. Me, you, and our brothers and sisters in Christ. While this cooking oil represents our church, where we grow as a family in Christ. So when God puts us in our current church, it is never a coincidence. We may come from a different background. We may come from a different family. We may come from a different school. But it all doesn't matter to God. Because when God unites us, He actually has a purpose. And what is the purpose? Let's see it in a while. Let me stir it for a little longer. And are you ready? And this is the purpose why God unites us as a family. Just wait for a while. The purpose is that we could have a special relationship and a very beautiful harmony. As a family of Christ, we could help each other, we can pray for one another, we care for one another as well. That is the beauty of having a family in Christ. Like this experiment, as you can see here, even though the food coloring is of different colors, like us, but it can create a very colorful life. So, be grateful because we have a family in Christ around us. So my experiment is very cool, right? So without further ado, let's watch Coco David, who will talk more about family in Christ. Bye-bye, kids!
Shalom, kids! Professor Andrileo showed us a very colorful experiment. You can try it at home later. In the past few weeks, we have learned a lot about family. We have learned that God gives us family. We have learned that we should honor our parents. And just like the previous weeks, today, we are going to learn something very special. The topic of today's Bible lessons is, we are part of a bigger family. Let's start with our Bible story today.
When the day of Pentecost came, Jesus' disciples were all together in one place. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak different languages. The Holy Spirit was giving them the power to speak these languages. When the people heard the noise, they were all surprised, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were all amazed and confused. They asked each other, "What does this mean?" But others were making fun of them, saying, "They have had too much wine." But Peter stood up with the 11 apostles. In a loud voice, he spoke to the crowd. "My fellow Jews, and all of you who are in Jerusalem, listen to me. Jesus from Nazareth was a very special man. God clearly showed this to you by the miracles, wonders, and signs that God did through him. You all know this because it happened right here among you. Jesus was given to you and you crucified him. But God knew all this would happen and God raised Jesus from death."
It was 10 days after Jesus was lifted up to heaven, and it was the day of Pentecost. The disciples were gathered in one place, and suddenly some noise came from heaven, and it sounded like a strong wind blowing. The disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit. The crowd heard the noise. Some were amazed, but some were mocking the disciples, and they said that the disciples were drunk. Peter stood up, and with a great courage, he preached about Jesus Christ. And what did the people do after listening to Peter? Let's continue our Bible story today.
The believers spent their time learning the apostles' teaching, and they continued to share, to break bread, and to pray together. Everyone felt great respect for God. All the believers stayed together. They shared everything. The believers met together in the temple every day. They all had the same purpose. They broke bread in their homes, happy to share their food with joyful hearts. They praised God, and all the people liked them. More and more people were being saved every day. The Lord was adding those people to the group of believers.
After they heard Peter's preaching, many of them repented. They changed their hearts, they changed their lives, and they were baptized. On that day, 3,000 people accepted Jesus as their God and their Savior. John 1 verse 12 says, "To all who receive Jesus and believe in His name, He gave the right to become children of God." On that day, 3,000 people became children of God. They became part of God's family because they received Jesus as their God and their Savior. And this is our first learning point today. When we receive and accept Jesus as our God and our Savior, we are part of God's family. The early church has a very unique lifestyle. Let's continue our Bible story to learn about their unique lifestyle.
When the people heard this, their hearts were so troubled. They asked Peter and the other apostles, "What shall we do?" Peter said to them, "Change your hearts and lives and be baptized, each one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This promise is for you and for your children and for everyone the Lord our God calls to Himself." Peter warned them with many other words. He also said, "Save yourselves from the evil of today's people." Then those people who accepted what Peter said were baptized. About 3,000 people were added to the number of believers that day.
Jesus said to his disciples, "A new command I give you. Love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another." And this is our second learning point today. In God's family, we need to love and care for one another. The early church lived according to Jesus' command. They love and care for one another. They share their food. They pray together. They help one another. You are part of God's family, so you can do it too. You can help your friends when they need help, or you can pray for them. In God's family, we need to help each other. We need to love and care for one another. Now, do you remember our two learning points today? Number one, we are part of God's family because we believe in Jesus. Number two, in God's family, we need to love and care for one another. Now, let's read our memory verse for today. A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. John 13, verse 34. Now, let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for making me part of your family. Help us, Lord, to do your command, to love and care for one another. We believe your Holy Spirit will help us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. See you.
Wow, that was an amazing message. Let's jump into our memory verse for the week.
A new command I give you. Love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. John 13, verse 34.
Now it's time to say goodbye, but I'll see you again next week. God bless you, Kids Army!